Hello and welcome back to Realm of Thrones, and it's been a little bit of time since the previous episode, because obviously I needed to spend a little bit of time doing some things, you know, for example, fighting bandits. I obviously just fought a bunch of those Lengi slavers and basically any bandit that I could get my hands on. Otherwise, apart from that, I did two tasks. Both of them were to eliminate brigands, of course, so you're not really missing too much. And also, as you can quite clearly tell, I've done some smithing, yes. And you may notice on my character over here, we have a new weapon. Now, this is a weapon that is specifically, keyed, but that doesn't really make sense. But anyway, it's specifically included, let's just use that word instead, in this mod. And the only reason why I was able to create this is because of the mod. I wouldn't normally be able to create this in the base game or any other mod unless that mod specifically has something available. Anyway, we're going to be taking Curious Smelter right here because that is literally one of the best things to take. Plus 100% learning rate of new parts. Fantastic. Otherwise, I did also level up just from my smithing, and we have one focus point to spend. Now, I am actually thinking that I might spec into engineering here. Now, the main reason why I'm thinking of specing into this and not into steward, even though steward is literally coming to a point where my learning rate is going to get capped out, is because I'm actually not going to be the steward for our party. That's the thing. I'm actually thinking that I will be the medic and the engineer. And then we have Jor-El, who is going to be our scout, obviously. As you know, she's already our scout. And we also have, we have yet to determine who is going to be our steward. But personally for me, I don't think we really need a steward super, super badly in the early game. Late game, however, it is going to be a necessity. So I'm going to be speccing into engineering here, even though I also would like to get some points into athletics, but I haven't actually fought on foot at all. So I think it's probably going to be a bit of a waste for me to put a focus point in that. We are only level 11 as well, so do bear that in mind. Otherwise, yes, there's war finally. As you can see, Calpono, in his infinite wisdom, decided that it would be a good idea to declare war against the Yi Ti. And hopefully we're going to be able to enter his army, or, you know, just generally help him out by going into the siege. And I would like to level up my engineering skill a little bit. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to join the continuing siege here. And hopefully I'm going to get some engineering skill as a result. I'm actually wondering whether I am going to get engineering skill, as you can see right there. That is very nice. And the Yi Ti, I think, are probably one of the... I would probably say that if you're going to be starting as the Yi Ti, good luck. That's all I can say. Good luck. Because they are quite clearly outmatched in almost every aspect. So I would definitely say that this is most likely basically hard mode. Because you could see here, look at this. They only have 200 defenders. It doesn't seem as though they have any militia whatsoever either. Which is, well, a huge disadvantage. Because usually, you know, if you go into a siege, you're going to have at least, what is it? I don't know, 400, maybe 500 militia, maybe, I don't know. It's probably going to be between 300 and 500 militia. And so usually you're going to be facing at least 600 troops, maybe 700, maybe 800, maybe even 1,000, dependent on, you know, who you're fighting. But yeah, as you can see, I have this wonderful pole arm now. It's using the most basic handle, so it isn't that long, which means that I will be able to use it in sieges, which is obviously the main purpose of this whole thing, because I wanted to try and be at least a little bit useful in sieges with this weapon. Even though I do have an Arak as well, I personally feel like it's going to be a fun idea to try to use this too. Okay, so I'm going to try to get in here, but this is going to be... Oh, no. Never mind. Yeah, you know what? I'll just let them go first. Am I actually even going to do anything here? Am I actually going to get any kills whatsoever? I'm actually thinking perhaps not. Oh, no. Get out of here. Get out of here. Get out. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Oh, nice. Nice. Oh, nice block. Nice block. Okay, here we go. Oh, I'm living. Can you believe it? Oh, I cannot believe it. Oh, yes. Nice hit. Okay, thank you. Can I get some more of this, please? Yes, can I get some more of this? We are leveling up so fast through this. We are leveling up so incredibly fast. Oh, yeah. We've gotten a massive amount of athletic skill. Kind of makes me think to myself, maybe I should have specced into athletics now, because just literally getting this amount of experience, it would have been dramatically increased. I actually thought that me specking into engineering would give me a pretty significant benefit, because I thought, hey, they're going to be doing, a lot of besieging, and I thought it would take them a lot longer to go in, but obviously I underestimated how weak the garrison was. I actually kind of thought, yeah, there's only 200 here, maybe it's a good idea for me to, not do that, but apparently no. Apparently they literally just don't care about, building anything. Ooh, I've got to be super careful here. These guys are definitely going to shoot me if they can. Oh yeah, here we go. Nice. Okay, no, don't get shot by that guy. Can I kill him? Oh no, I couldn't see him. Oh, it was the darkness. All right, well, never mind. It's fine. We got a good amount of kills, which is all that I really desired, let's face it. That is exactly what we want out of a siege. We got a good amount of kills. We got 20 kills. That was our first ever siege. I have, well, relatively poor stats. My polearm skill is okay, but it is definitely not the best. It could definitely be better, but the whole point of it is that we have now captured this particular thief, which obviously, if you think about it, isn't really going to help me at all, because I don't really care about this. This is not really my thing. This is much more for the Dothraki, and they have already been destroyed. As you can see, the ET have already been destroyed very, very fast indeed. All right, who is this? Jillian of the Rills. Okay, I have no idea what she's about. I really wish that I could see her other stats. I don't know about you, but she has basically only two stats here, bows and athletics. I can't see her other stats, which I gotta say is a bit disappointing. I've said this before and I've mentioned this in another series, and for me personally, I feel like it is a huge, huge disadvantage to not know specifically what a companion's stats actually are. Because obviously you're gonna see the most prominent statistics that someone has, but that's it. You're not going to be able to see anything else, which is a huge problem, in my opinion, at least. Anyway, I don't even know what to do here, to be honest. I don't have anything to equip. Jor-El apparently wanted to equip some stuff. I'm just going to sell some things, I suppose. Sell these. We do have a couple of harnesses and so on that we could absolutely sell for 6,000. Oh yeah, by the way, I also have a caravan running too. The main reason why I wanted a caravan is just in case I didn't actually have the ability to enter any kind of battle, I would have a small amount of passive benefit. And that's it. That was literally the only reason. I'm going to be going for combat movement speed. That is always what I end up taking. I personally prefer that over the HP. Even though HP is relatively decent, let's face it. HP is... coupled with the other HP increasing perks, can be very effective. But by itself, I don't really think it does too much. I would like to actually go into a battle here with these guys, but this is highly unlikely. This is kind of awful, isn't it? Yeah, this is pretty awful. I'm gonna go in here just purely for the fact that I would like to try out this polearm on horseback. I have actually not tried it out ever before, so that's the reason why I was actually very impressed with myself, that is, in that siege, because I thought to myself, wow, I'm actually not doing too badly with this. I thought that I was not going to be getting many kills. I literally thought at the very start when I fell off the wall, I thought, oh yeah, this is going to be one of those times, isn't it? It's going to be one of those times where I literally just get shot in the face or slashed in the face or something in the face, and then I fall off the wall and then die instantly and don't get any kills. I was literally thinking that that was going to be my fate. But no, I was actually able to achieve a little bit more than that. And actually got some pretty decent, pretty decent gains from it, actually. So I'm really, really pleased about that. Now, technically, here's the thing. I actually wanted to create this polearm with a much longer reach. Because obviously, if you think about it, you know, having a longer reach definitely helps on horseback. And generally, it is going to make a massive difference to you and your effectiveness. But unfortunately, I wasn't able to for a variety of reasons. You know, one, I didn't actually want to make it a damaged or rusty or, you know, broken weapon, because it was far above my smithing skill. So I didn't really want to do that. Oh, we actually gained 5.4 influence from it. And two, I kind of wanted it to, as I said to you before, when I was in the siege, I actually wanted it to be somewhat effective in a siege situation. And that's it. Those are the things. Those are the reasons. But yeah, as I say, if you're thinking that you yourself are going to be entering a lot of field battles and you don't care so much about sieges, or you have a weapon that you want to use in a siege specifically, so, you know, a sidearm of some kind, then you can definitely use it like that. That's going to be a lot more effective for you, potentially. Anyway, as you can see, I do have a lot of weapons right here. I'm going to actually be keeping those for the inevitable, of course. You know how it is. We're just going to be keeping those for our, smithing and so on. And let's actually just take a quick look. I actually did advance in level. So here's the thing. I really do want to level engineering, but I feel like that is a huge, huge sink of a lot of focus points, when I just think that it's just like, well, what is the point in this? What is the point in taking this right now if I'm barely going to be doing any sieges? I'm kind of thinking of maybe charm skill here. What else do we have available in charm skill that I would like to get? What's actually useful? Well, Warlord would be very useful. Warlord would actually be very, very useful indeed. So I'm actually going to go for another point in that. We should probably... Now I'm having an issue, because we have an attribute point and I would like to spend it in something that is actually going to be beneficial. I'm thinking right now that I will go for intelligence, just one more, and probably one more point in intelligence. I would like to give, well, hopefully I would like to get this. Minister of Health is one of the most powerful perks in the game, just purely for the fact that it gives you so many hit points for your army. I mean, if you think about this, look at this, plus one hit point to troops for every skill point above 250, and you get this at 275. So you're effectively giving hundreds of HP, effective HP's worth, to your troops. Because each individual troop gains 25. So obviously, you know, if you have 10, then that's 250. If you have 1,000 troops, then that's obviously a lot more, you know. But obviously, you're not going to have 1,000 troops most of the time. But the point still stands, you know, it's relatively decent, you know, it gives you a lot of stuff, you know, so I quite like that. Anyway, let's actually just take a quick look here. Yeah, we will go for more riders. I still need to get, what do I need to get? I need to get Veterans Respect, don't I? Yes, Veterans Respect is all the way up here. Oh dear, yeah, it's going to take me quite some time, but it is leveling up. It is actually leveling up quite nicely. Anyway, there is actually a tournament going on here, and there are heavy Warlord Pauldrons available. So I'm kind of thinking, hey, that sounds like a pretty nice reward for us. Even if we don't end up using it, it could be relatively useful for Jor-El or any one of our other companions, of which we have zero. We don't have any other companions at the moment. But you never know, maybe we will at some point. And in which case, oh no, Bortu is here. Get him. Get Bortu. We really do not want him here. There we go. There we are. We eliminated him. Thank you very much. There's actually another fellow in here as well. This guy needs to go away. Is that the guy? Oh, I have no idea. I can't tell which one's the higher level. Oh no. This might be problematic. I think it might be him. He seems to be taking a bit of a battering and not really caring too much. Oh no, it's this guy. It's this guy. Get him. Get him. Unfortunately, me fighting on horseback is a little bit of a pitiful sight, especially with the one-handed. Ah, there we go. We actually did manage to hit him as well. Oh, nice, nice double hit. Nice, he blocked the wrong direction. A bit weird. All right, that's absolutely fine. Hopefully we're not gonna die here. Hopefully we will be able to get my forces actually involved. What are they doing right now? Whoa, this guy is an absolute beast of blocking. Wow, look at that. He's a bob. He's a bob. Yeah, it's a beast of blocking. Get it? Yeah. Anyway, there we go. Nice. We were able to actually make it through. Unfortunately, Mahir is also getting through, and that is not good. Okay, wait a minute. I do have a one-handed here, so I don't have to suffer with the spear. Okay, come on, face me. Yes, there we go. That's what we want. Yes, there we go. Nice. Okay, great. If my fellow could actually do some damage, because he's a horse archer, he should technically have a much better time of doing damage against a Dothraki barbarian. But apparently he was just absolutely useless. No idea why that was. Anyway, we've got a one hand. Oh, no. Okay, wait a minute. We've got a thrust. Thrust? Yes, we've got a thrust. We will thrust against him. I'm sure he will enjoy it. There we go. For all of 2 seconds. There we are. Wonderful. And indeed, we are now fighting Mahir, which is not great. Not a big fan. Oh, never mind. 102 damage. 102, and it still wasn't a kill. So that means he has the that perk, you know? He has that perk that increases his HP by 5, which is very funny, actually, because, I mean, it literally just saved his life, isn't it? Anyway, the only reason why I did this tournament, by the way, is for the 6 renown, even though I can get renown from other sources, maybe much easier. I kind of felt, hey, you know what? If there's a good reward, then we might as well do it. And the Warlord Pauldrons are pretty nice. I mean, you can see here that I already have relatively decent armor. So we're just going to see what happens with this. Yeah, there we go. Jor-El is also going to now be equipping the other ones that we had. And that's great. In my opinion, upgrading our companion is just as important as upgrading ourselves, because obviously we do not want her to die. If she dies, then it's going to be a bit of a mess, because, I mean, it's not that bad, obviously, but we have been literally leveling up her scouting skill, and she's actually doing relatively well right now. So I'd like to try to foster that as much as we possibly can. I'm going to go for Sweeping Wind here as well, even though usually I will take Sagittarius almost every single time. I'm not actually using a bow, so there's no point. There is no point in me doing that. I will, however, be taking Hard Knock as well. This is also going to increase my infantry hit points. That's actually something that I think I might also be doing later on down the line. I might actually be respecing my athletics perk. You know, the one that I just took that gave me combat movement speed? Because if you take a look at this, this gives me 3 hit points to infantry, right? 3 hit points to infantry in my party, plus this, which gives me plus 5 hit points to, well, basically foot troops, so archers and infantry. So that's 8, right? So that's 8. And then, on top of that, we obviously have medicine, which is going to give me another 25. So you can see how this is going to build up. And eventually, it's going to be giving us an insanely strong, very resilient army. Obviously, if we're going to be going up against Daenerys, which we will be, it's going to be a bit of a... Well, she's going to have a dragon, so that might be a bit difficult. It might be a bit difficult. Anyway... yeah, we're going to be going for this because she is... Oh, she's actually not mounted. Never mind, she's actually not mounted. So I will be taking Shield Bearer instead. And let's have a look here. All right, so we can finally get Pathfinder and increase our movement speed. This is going to be extremely useful for us. I don't really care about sight range, so movement speed is what we'll go for. And we want deserts and dunes, don't we? Yes, this is so much more useful in my opinion, so we'll be taking that too. And we'll go for another focus point in scouting here and another focus point in cunning. Maybe at some point she might be specking into combat skills again or something else, but her main purpose is literally just to be a scout. And that's it. So that's what we're doing. Anyway, we're just going to go straight on in here, fight some Lengi slavers. Obviously, we're basically done with the YT now, which is somewhat unfortunate. I was actually really hoping we would have a slightly longer battle. But what can you do? You know, what can you do? That's just how it is sometimes. Oh, nice damage. Wow, that was actually really, really good. Okay, I was kind of hoping that we would be able to do some really, really nice attacks with this weapon, and indeed, it looks as though we are. Look at that. It's doing so much damage right now. Oh yeah, I actually need to show you the weapon as well. I was actually going to call it something really awesome, but unfortunately, the when I crafted it, it didn't actually save the name. I don't know why. I think I might have entered the name in the wrong box or whatever. But I did want to call it something very funny. But yes, or at least I thought it was funny. Maybe it's not funny to you. I don't know. But yeah, I actually would have very much preferred to have a funny sounding, well, shall we say, a funnily named weapon over a weapon that is just called Crafted One-Handed Polearm, or Crafted Two-Handed Polearm, or whatever it's called right now. You know, it would have been a much more amusing thing to have, but yeah, you know how it is. Anyway, there we are. We were able to achieve victory. This is basically what I have been doing off screen as well. I have basically just been running around attacking as many Lengi slavers as I can get my hands on, and it's actually proven to be extremely, extremely effective, especially considering right now I am a mercenary, and that is entirely... That is the only reason why it's actually good. I mean, obviously, to be fair, it is going to be good nevertheless, because you're going to be getting a lot of loot and you're going to be getting a lot of, you know, renown and so on and so forth. And that's all wonderful. That's all great. Because obviously, I don't know whether you noticed already, but I did actually advance to Clan Tier 2 as well. So that's good, you know. But generally, obviously, if you have a mercenary contract with someone, it is just inherently so much better, because you're going to be getting influence, and it's just going to generally give you so much more of a benefit. And you can see here, how many times can I go into fighting some of these fellows, and literally, just as you see the level ups that I'm getting right now, the level ups, huge amounts of experience being gained right here. And otherwise, we're just going to go for some more riders. These fellows all require veterans' respect, by the way. That's why I can't level them up, unfortunately. But I am going to need to go and get some more war mounts. I do need to get some more war mounts, so that's what I'll probably be doing in just a second, because there is actually a horse village nearby, if you can believe it. There is actually one right over there, and I think I'm probably going to be going there in just a moment. Let's just go into these fellows right here, just fight them real fast. And we are, of course, leveling up my medicine skill in the meantime too. We are almost at Doctor's Oath, which, as I said to you before, is literally one of my favorite perks ever for leveling up medicine skill. It is basically secret OP. Really? A crash? I'm actually really surprised. What is the problem with it? I'm having a look at the crash report right now. Let me actually just have a look. Get navigation mesh center position. What? The problem is what? What is? Oh, the problem is the sandbox mod. Okay, that's a base game problem. All right, so I'm back, and well, thankfully it hasn't crashed again. So I have no idea. Usually, Realm of Thrones is one of the most stable mods for me, and I very rarely have crashes with it. So I'm not sure. Maybe I have to verify game cache or something like that on Steam. Maybe that's going to be something that will help me out. Anyway, we're here. We got some Dothraki courses available. I'm going to get 4 of those. Whoa, that's a lot. All right, that's very expensive, isn't it? Okay, I certainly wasn't expecting it to be that much, but sure. Okay, I'm just going to trade a bunch of my loot for all of those horses. Don't really see a problem with that, to be honest. And, oh yeah, there's my caravan person, by the way. He's just running around randomly doing whatever he likes. And yeah, we are otherwise going to be heading down here. Hopefully it won't crash again when it gets to a certain point. I'm actually wondering whether it was to do with the date. Hopefully there wasn't something that was happening specifically that was going to cause it to have a problem. But I'm just going to crash. No. Don't do that. I'm just going to save. Yes, just going to save. And then we'll make our way over to Dothraki territory. I would like to actually do a little bit of raiding. It's very true that someone actually mentioned that it would probably be very in keeping and very thematic for us to do a little bit of raiding. Did I say trading or raiding? I'm actually not sure now. Oh no. Never mind. Anyway, I said raiding, right? Didn't I say raiding? Ah, well, it doesn't matter. If I said trading, then I meant raiding. Anyway, otherwise, what we're going to do is I'm also going to purchase a bunch of these. Should I purchase a bunch of these or should I not? I actually feel like maybe I shouldn't. Okay, we'll purchase some storage. Some storage mounts. I think that's probably going to be a little bit more useful for us right now. And we're just going to sell all of these. Oh yeah, look at that. Large bag of light bodkin arrows. Sells for 1,200. I mean, really. That's absolute insanity right there. Anyway, what I would actually very much love to do is I would love to find some Pugios or something relatively powerful. That's a nice weapon right there. Looks cool. Looks cool. 36,000 though. Probably not going to be buying that. Oh, there's Hodor. Nice. All right, let's get him, shall we? Let's get him. Can I actually get him?
Hey.
He's going to be extremely expensive, isn't he? What? He's only 600? All right, sure. That's interesting. Okay, that's very, very interesting indeed. What is he actually using right now? He's using absolutely terrible gear, as you might expect. All right, well, I have no shield for him or anything like that, so we're going to have to fight some stuff. Now that I found him, I'm literally just going to save because I'm a bit worried that he's going to leave or that I'm going to crash and then he, you know, I'm going to lose the fact that we have him now. That's amazing, though. I really wasn't expecting to find him. He's got 250 in his combat skills. He's absolutely insane. He's going to be so incredibly strong for us. Obviously, he is probably going to be fighting us in tournaments and things, so maybe it's not a good idea that I take him along, but well, if it happens, it happens, you know. That's just how we're going to have to do things. But yeah, otherwise, apart from that, all we can really do is maybe hope that we get... Oh, there's actually a task here. Oh, I was kind of hoping for a merchant caravan task. There is a tournament going on here as well. A stitched cured leather coat might be decent for Hodor, actually. So I'm thinking, hey, you know what? Maybe we should do that. Maybe we should do it. Yeah, it's actually not too bad. I mean, it's, you know, it's not as amazing as what you could possibly get from, I don't know, anywhere, from any marketplace. It's okay. You know, it's a pretty standard looking... pretty standard looking chest piece, but it's going to be decent enough, I suppose. Oh, I can't believe that. Did you see that? Wow, that was pretty hilarious. Okay, so these guys, yes, there we go. All right, can we do some damage here? Yes, we can. Yes, we can. Can I actually eliminate this guy? Yes, I can. There we go. Very nice. Okay, come on now. No. You're not going to run away from me, sir. Yes, there we are. Nice 50 damage right there. That was the finishing blow. Oh, wow. Yeah, some of these fellas. Hodor is actually doing a really good job of staying alive. He's playing the Bee Gees right now. Well, not anymore. There you go. His Apple Vision Pro ran out of batteries or whatever. Yeah. You've seen that thing? That is pretty crazy. Yeah, I have no idea what it would be like to wear one of those, but yeah, that's... it's certainly a thing, isn't it? Certainly one of those, you know, cultural phenomenons that just pops up and then it's just like, well, it's very expensive. That's pretty much what it comes down to, isn't it? Anyway, otherwise, oh, 79 damage, what? Okay, that's gonna cost him. He'll wish that he went for an Apple Vision Pro instead of entering this tournament, even though he's probably doing this to get the money to actually get one, right? Oh, yeah, probably, I don't know. I'm not particularly interested in it myself, but I am interested in winning this tournament. Let's do it. Okay, wait a minute. Let's have a look here. There he is. Oh no, it's a slashing polearm. I actually thought it was a thrusting polearm for a second because we got one just now. And I thought, oh no, it's another thrusting one. And that's why I was going straight at him. That was a huge mistake on my part. That could have ended very badly. But thankfully not. There we go. We were able to do it. Now, the best thing that we want to do is we want to... We want to fight some Lengi slavers so that we can get some gear for Hodor. That's going to be extremely extremely important for us. I would like to try and pick up some additional companions, if at all possible, as well. There you go. Hodor is obviously going to be equipping some things. As you can see, he's already gotten some decent stuff. Nothing amazing, of course, but, you know, it's good enough at the moment. just to fight slavers and things like that. Obviously, it's not going to be great for fighting vassals. So we're just going to continue doing our thing, continue recruiting and so on, and then we are going to be relatively good. I am thinking right now that what I might do is I might try to attack some caravans, but I'm not sure if we can actually pull that off without being kicked out of the faction. Because I don't really want to be kicked out as a mercenary right now, because this is extremely lucrative, as you've no doubt seen. It's extremely good for us right now. Let me actually just take a quick look. Hodor has riding skill, right? Does he? No. He's not going to have riding skill. No, he has 60. He actually has 60 in riding skill, so that's not too bad. So technically, he could use a horse. Let me actually have a look here. Yeah, he could actually use a Dothraki courser as well. I'm using a Dothraki courser. Jor-El doesn't have any riding skill, so that's absolutely fine. Okay, yeah, sure, why not? Let's make him into a... it's kind of interesting, isn't it? All right, yeah, let's make him into this. Let's give him a spear. Let's get make him just upgrade all his stuff. There we are. And he's gonna be feeling pretty good right now, or at least I hope so. I mean, we're trying to take pretty special care of him right now. I don't really want him to die. Yeah. And otherwise, we can now head down into Targaryen territory, because I would kind of like to push the pressure a little bit down there. I'd like to make it so that we have a bit more of a... a bit more aggression in that area, because as it stands right now, we're not really getting anything like that happening. And I'd kind of like to push them into a bit of a... You know, a bit of a skirmish situation, maybe. I think that might be quite fun to do. So what we're going to do is we're going to... Oh, no, I didn't want to go here. I did actually want to go into the marketplace here, or the buying place, shall we say. Oh, yeah, by the way, I have 428 parts of wrought iron. I should probably sell this. I should probably sell a couple of pieces of this. It doesn't really matter. You know, it's super, super easy to come by. Oh, yeah, by the way, I haven't shown you my weapon yet. Here's the weapon. It's called Crafted Two-Handed Polearm, which I definitely didn't want it to be called. It is a tier 6 weapon, because hilariously enough, I had 2 pieces of fine steel, or 3 pieces of fine steel, or whatever it was, and I was able to use those to create the polearm's cutting area, the head of the weapon. And that was the entire reason why I was able to even create it. I can actually show you, I can show you the smithing menu if you don't believe me or whatever, but yeah, anyway, let's go down to Tolos, I suppose, and we'll see whether we can actually get something done there with some caravans or something like that. Maybe we can see what's going on with that. I mean, I could technically attack basically any caravan that we want, I think. I'm not sure, actually. I don't think that's really going to make any difference to relations. But who knows? That's the thing. I kind of don't want to chance it, just in case. Oh, escort merchant caravan. Okay, that's going to be something that I would like to do. Okay, so first of all, what we want to do is we want to select two-handed polearm. So you can see here, these are the two blades that I had the ability to choose between. I chose this one because it does more damage. That's it. That was the only reason. It just does more damage, right? And I've already unlocked a whole bunch of different, polearm parts. Obviously, they're very low tier. But you can see here that I had, 3 pieces of fine steel. I don't know where I got the fine steel from. I can only assume that I smelted some weapon or another that just gave me a little bit of fine steel. And maybe I got another one and gave me another little bit of fine steel. And that's what I did. So, yeah. That was pretty much it. So then I basically just crafted that. And I made it with this, which is the Dragonstone. Actually, I didn't even use that. I used this one. This is the one that I used. Yeah, as you can see. Because this one is 88 reach, so it's basically like a hammer or something like that instead of a proper polearm. So I use this, which is of course the tier 1, it's the tier 1 handle, and I needed to do that, otherwise I would have used this one, which is the extra long mahogany shaft. But you can see here that the difficulty is dramatically increased, And because I only had 3 fine steel, I didn't want to go and make something that was negative damage or anything like that. I didn't want any kind of penalty on the craft. Cool thing about this though, I obviously have some hardwood that I can do, so we're just going to do a little bit of that. As you can see, we got back up to 60 in smithing, and then we can do a little bit of this. You're going to see a bunch of smithing parts being unlocked now as well, which is extremely important for us if we actually want to make something a little bit later on. And I am going to be escorting the caravan myself. Let's actually see if there's something. Ooh, hello. All right, so there is actually a companion here. I'm going to get her. She's going to be extremely cheap, as you can see. And we are literally just going to speak to this guy. Form a caravan. She's going to be the leader, and there we have it. So we've got two. Well, I've got one caravan that I am running after myself. Oh, can I go onto the water? Yes, I can go onto the water. I was a bit worried there for a second. I was a bit worried because I was a bit more used to how other mods do it. Where you need a ship, and I thought to myself, no, that would have been terrible. Okay, yeah, thankfully that is absolutely fine, and we can head in here and do some damage. We can actually do some really, really nice damage, and we don't have to worry so much about being eliminated.
Bruh.
That quickly? Or maybe I do. Or maybe I do. didn't I just say, yeah, I said in another episode of another series, I said, you know what, I should probably just not mention anything like that, nothing to do with my HP, just don't mention any of those things, because it seems to me like that is what always happens. It's always a case of, you know, I'm doing all right, he says, as he gets absolutely murdered, almost. But yeah, we're getting some really, really nice influence for this as well, which is super, super good. I'm actually not going to be taking these prisoners right here. I have a lot of prisoners right now, and I'd like to keep those as the ones that are being converted to join us. And they're going to be, obviously, in my opinion at least, probably the best for us. I actually don't know. Do Lengi slavers actually advance in level? Let me actually see. Let me get these guys. Let me see here. Mounted slaver. No, they don't. Oh, well, that's a bit sad, isn't it? But they do have some relatively solid stats, and their gear is actually not bad at all, as you can see. And they're actually using a glaive as well, which is a very nice weapon. So I suppose we don't have to worry about them too much, but I would prefer, if we can, at some point, to go for... maybe some noble troops from the Dothraki. I think that could probably be a little bit more effective, of course. Anyway, we're just going to wait here for these guys to come out. There we are. They're now traveling to Mantaris. Okay, they're fighting. Really? Broken men? Okay, I'm just going to go in and auto-resolve against these guys. Not even going to bother fighting those fellows because there's literally just 11 of them. That doesn't really make any sense. Ah, we have another 40. Did you see those guys up there? Oh yeah, they're waiting for us. Okay, there we go. There are the raiders. I'm just going to go straight in and attack them. Oh wow, they actually caught up. I can't believe it. I really cannot believe it. Okay. Yeah, well, that's absolutely fine. Ooh, my medicine skill is almost 75. Ah, can you tell that I'm so excited about that? Oh yeah. Because once we get 75 in medicine, it is just going to skyrocket. It is literally going to be night and day as to how fast it is to level up. It's so, so good. Anyway, Mantaris, I don't even know how many stops we have to make. Do we have to make 3? Yeah, 3 stops, as I thought. Okay, that's absolutely fine. Ah, Astapor. Okay, so that's all the way back here. I mean, I wish they'd make up their mind, actually, because it's kind of a bit weird how they were like, oh, yeah, we're just going to go this way now. Because they could have gone down to Astapor before. But they obviously decided not to do that. We're going to get attacked. Yep, there we go. There it is. Let's go in here. Attack them. There we are. Once again, not going to be taking these guys, even though we could potentially sell them. But I don't really have that much roguery skill anyway. And we're probably just going to get, what, 500 gold or something like that for it. Not really going to be that useful. Anyway, there we have it. Oh, we got another fellow right here. Maybe we want to get him. Oh, he's got some good stats. He's got some good stats right here. Look at this guy. All right. Maybe we want to make him into a caravan person, even though he is actually a very good companion. He's 3,400, as you might expect. He's got some great, great stats. All right, so let's see what we can do here. Here we are. There we are. Yep, nice. Okay, now let's actually have a look. Do they have any Pugios? I'm still looking for Pugios, even though it's probably not going to happen. No, doesn't seem like it. All right, well, we're just going to get Hodor equipped with some of the old stuff that we have right here. 2,600 from that, 3,400 from this. And we also have some smithing skill, of course. And, well, let's see. No, we should be perfectly fine. And I'm going to... that's the thing. I'm not sure whether they're going to declare war on us if we attack some of their caravans. I guess we're going to try it. I guess we're going to try it and we'll see what happens. Anyway, I will be going for... Let's see. We're going to go for heroic leader, I think. Because even though the party size limit at this point in the game could be relatively useful, I think heroic leader with the plus 10% battle morale penalty to enemies, I think that is just far and away going to be the best. So we'll go for that. And I'm thinking right now that maybe I want to go... We should probably go for some more athletic skill, all things considered, shouldn't we? We should probably do that. But I don't want to. You know why? Because I want to go for this. I want to go for medicine skill. Should I do that? Oh, yeah. Okay, fine. I'm gonna bite the bullet. Why not? Let's do it. Anyway, that is probably going to be it for this episode. Next time, we're going to be fighting a couple of caravans. We're going to see whether we can spark some kind of war, some kind of skirmish with someone else. Or maybe the Dothraki are just going to declare war by themselves. And we'll see what happens as well. I thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.